FreeBSD not only makes for a fantastic and efficient server OS, used by thousands of admins throughout the world, but it's also a brilliant platform for people who code. But what about non-admins and non-coders? Well, in this video we'll be showing you 10 applications used by 10 different types of creators that can also use FreeBSD to get things done. Blender is a free and open source 3D computer graphics software tool used for creating animated films, visual effects, 3D printed models, motion graphics, interactive 3D applications, virtual reality, and assets for video games. Initially released in 1994 as closed source software, then as freeware in 1998, it was released as open source in 2002. You can even edit videos with it. But that's not where its strengths lay. Kdenlive is a free and open source multi-track video editing software based on the MLT framework and Qt. The project was started by Jason Wood in 2002 and it became part of the official KDE project suite in 2015. Kdenlive makes use of MLT, FreeRFX, SOX and LADSPA libraries, and supports all of the formats supported by FMPEG or LibAV. Inkscape is a free and open source vector graphics editor for Linux, FreeBSD, as well as Windows and macOS, and was initially released in 2003. Inkscape isn't for artists in the classical sense. It does lack some features found in some bigger suites, but for graphic and text manipulation, LaTeX support and extensive SVG filter support, it packs a big punch. It has been likened and compared to Adobe Illustrator. The GIMP, which is an acronym of GNU Image Manipulation Program, is a free and open source raster graphics editor used for image editing and freeform drawing. It has often been compared to and suggested as a possible replacement for Adobe Photoshop. The initial release was in 1996 and has been continually developed ever since, with the next major branch, 3.0, coming in 2024's second quarter. Although it is not designed to be used for drawing, some artists and creators have used it this way to great success, though perhaps Krita might be a better choice. Released in 2001, Scribus is a free and open source desktop publishing software available for most desktop operating systems. It is designed for layout, typesetting, and preparation of files for professional quality image setting equipment, and can also create animated and interactive PDF presentations and forms. It also comes with a selection of wizards, so if you lack inspiration, you can have a look to see what can whet your appetite. Audacity is a free and open source digital audio editor and recording application software that was initially released during May 2000. In addition to recording audio for multiple sources, Audacity can be used for post-processing of all types of audio, including effects such as normalization, trimming, and fading in and out. It supports a wide selection of plugins to extend its abilities. In April 2021, it was announced that the Muse Group, owners of MuseScore and Ultimate Guitar, would acquire the Audacity trademark and continue to develop the application, which remains free and open source despite initial concerns. MuseScore is a music notation program that is available for a wide variety of operating systems and was released in 2002. MuseScore's main purpose is the creation of high-quality engraved musical scores in a what-you-see-is-what-you-get environment. There are predefined templates for many types of ensembles, and like Audacity, functionality can be extended by making use of the many freely available plugins. Although MuseScore itself is open source, the MuseScore company uses income from their commercial sheet music sharing service to support the development of the free notation software. In 2017, the MuseScore company was acquired by Ultimate Guitar, which added full-time paid developers to the open source team. In 2021, the MuseScore company, Ultimate Guitar, and other properties, including Audacity, were put under a new parent company, the Muse Group. LibreOffice Writer is the free and open source word processor and desktop publishing component of the LibreOffice software package. It's similar to Microsoft Word with many similar features and file format compatibility. The LibreOffice suite itself was forked in 2010 from OpenOffice.org, an open source version of the earlier StarOffice. The LibreOffice suite consists of programs for word processing, creating and editing spreadsheets, slideshows, diagrams and drawings, and working with databases. KXStitch is a program that lets you create cross-stitch patterns and charts. Patterns can be created from scratch on a user-defined size of grid, which can be enlarged or reduced in size as your pattern progresses. Alternatively, you can import images from many graphic file formats, which will allow you to reduce the number of colors and to restrict conversion to a full stitches or optionally use fractional stitches. You may also use images as backgrounds, allowing you to trace over them. These imported images can be modified using the supply tools to produce your final design. LeoCAD is a free and open source 3D computer-aided design program for creating virtual Lego models by using parts from the LD Draw library, and it has over 10,000 different pieces created by the LD Draw community. You can rotate the view perspective and have multiple views at the same time. The timeline automatically tracks your progress and can be used to create building instructions with multiple steps. It was developed by Leonardo Zaid in 1997. Hopefully, these 10 different programs used by 10 different types of creators might make you think that FreeBSD is not only a fantastic server and coding platform, but also can help fire your imagination too in other aspects. If you found this video useful, then please consider giving it a thumbs up. And if you found more than one video useful, then please consider subscribing. And if you do subscribe, then hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any new videos. I do all the videos myself on this channel. I use FreeBSD and the tools associated to do it. I don't use AI. It's all me, with me, just my passion and my interest in FreeBSD. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.